Hi, I'm George Hirsch. Welcome to George Hirsch Lifestyle. I'm going to share with you my recipe for simple country comforts with my savory waffles. Let's get started with my cheddar and dill, which will be the actually first part of the waffle and kind of like the highlight of the main ingredient. You know, most people are usually used to having waffles with syrup and kind of on the sweet side, but waffles eaten throughout the day and served with a little fried chicken and savory seasonings actually taste really, really good. So I started here with 2 cups of flour and 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda and then 2 tablespoons of granulated sugar, which will be a little sweetness. It needs a little sweetness in the flour. So the real benefit of these waffles in my recipe is separating the yolks from the whites. By doing this, you're actually going to get a much lighter batter. I want to make sure, of course, that your egg whites are always in an oil-free bowl, that there's no grease in it, and that is really going to help the whites really whip up to a much lighter consistency. So always start on a lower speed just until the whites begin to break up. You'll stop it when it gets a light whip mark within the egg whites. Now you can see those strands starting to work its magic. And just think, all the air that's going in the meringue is actually going to wind up in the batter, making it nice and fluffy. Okay, now that our whites are nice and light and fluffy, we'll just break up our yolk slightly and then just add a few drops of the milk in first. Make a nice well within the batter. And then slowly add in the milk. Don't add it in all in one shot. As the batter starts to absorb farm fresh milk, which I'm using, which is a little creamier than general homogenized milk. As soon as all the milk is absorbed, now I can fold in my egg whites. And again, the egg whites, you want to fold them in thirds, small amount at a time, because as the egg whites get folded, they are breaking down and some of the air is coming out of it. But each time you add in the egg whites, the meringue, it lightens up the batter really nice. And then the remainder of the egg whites. And then as soon as you see almost the last of the meringue being folded in, then we'll add in the butter. We didn't add the butter in before. There's 1/3 cup of butter, 5 tablespoons. We didn't add the butter in earlier because butter would have immediately made the meringue break down. Now I'll add in the savory. I'll fold in a small amount of cheddar cheese and a small amount of dill, a couple tablespoons of both. Fold it into the batter, get it evenly mixed in. Once everything's been mixed in there, we can take a ladle, have a waffle iron that's preheated. This is a Belgian waffle iron. You can make these with regular size. I like the Belgium pretty much because they come out nice and thick. So if I'm serving it with some nice chicken, it kind of goes really nice as a side dish. Close it, and you need to let it go for 3 minutes on each side. Okay, let's check the first waffle. Oh, it looks great. Oh, perfect. Absolutely perfect. I'll load it up with more batter. So we'll have plenty of waffles. Excellent. Oh my God, the aroma that comes off the waffles. It's just great. Okay, for the waffles that came off, I'm just gonna dress them up with a little bit of cheddar cheese on top while they're still warm. And sprinkle a small amount more of the dill on top. I'm diving right in.
So there you have it, my country comfort inspired dishes. Light and steamy dill and cheddar waffle.
If I can do it, you can do it. We'll see you real soon. Really good. Really, really good.
For more on recipes, entertaining lifestyle tips, TV series blog, and selected video clips from today's show, join me at chefgeorgehirsch.com.